Hi, I'm Andrew Bowers, Product Manager for Developer Products at Google. Today I'm going to give you an early look at Java language support on App Engine. I'll guide you through the development of a simple guestbook application, from creation to deployment. Let's get started. I'll start by opening up the Eclipse IDE. Here I have the standard Java perspective, and you can see a few extra toolbar icons at the top left. We've extended the environment with the Google plugin for Eclipse, providing support for Google Web Toolkit and App Engine. Of course, you can also develop using another IDE or from the command line if you wish. To create a new project, I'm going to click on the blue G in the top left. This brings up the new web application project wizard. I'll enter in a project name and a package for my project. I can also choose whether to use App Engine or Google Web Toolkit with the project. Choosing these will configure the starter project differently, depending on which you pick. For this example, I'm going to create a simple JSP servlet, so I'll uncheck Google Web Toolkit and click OK. The project wizard has now created a template project that I can edit and run. Taking a look inside the project, you'll notice that it's a standard J2EE type servlet project that can be run on any J2EE container. There's a source directory which contains our Java source files, like you'd expect, the App Engine and Java Virtual Machine SDK libraries, and finally a web archive, or WAR directory. App Engine uses a standard Java web archive directory as its deployment directory. You put the files you want to deploy to App Engine into this directory, including static files, JSPs, and your compiled class files. Going back to the source directory, you'll notice that there is a standard Java servlet file. This file responds to an HTTP request and outputs Hello World. Let's try it out locally. In order to do that, I need a server. Luckily, App Engine ships with a development web server that mimics the production environment. This enables you to download the SDK and immediately start developing on your local machine. I'll start the local server by choosing Debug Web Application. This starts the server on port 8080. Navigating to this URL, I see Hello World. We now have the foundation for our project. Let's add the source files that we need for a guestbook application. This application is going to consist of three basic source files. First, we'll have a guestbook.jsp file that contains the HTML form for creating a new entry. That will post to a guestbook servlet, which will accept the form variables and create a guestbook entry object. We'll then save that object to the Datastore and redirect back to the JSP page. Finally, the JSP page will list out all of the guestbook entries in the Datastore. I've already written most of the code for those three files. I'll import them into my project. And I'll drag the JSP file into the web archive directory. Finally, I want to modify the WebXML configuration file to point to my new JSP. I'll do that by opening up the WebXML and changing the welcome file entry. Let's run this again, and you'll see that I have a simple HTML form that submits, but it doesn't store anything to the Datastore yet. Let's take care of that next. App Engine's Datastore is built on top of Bigtable, a scalable, distributed storage platform. In addition to low-level Datastore APIs, we provide standards-based APIs in the form of Java Data Objects and Java Persistence API. JDO and JPA are Java standards for persisting plain Java objects to a data store. They're data store agnostic, mapping to relational databases, XML, or in our case, the App Engine data store. This means I can write a Java class and persist those objects directly to the data store without having to read and write specific fields to and from a table. In this example, we'll use JDO. I'd like to store the guestbook entry objects. In order to do that, I simply annotate the class. JDO then performs a step called enhancement, where it will modify the bytecode of the class so that it can persist to the data store. First, I'll import the annotation classes. Next, I'll add an annotation to the class that indicates it is capable of persistence. Third, I'll annotate the fields I wish to save with the persistent annotation from JDO. And finally, every object in JDO must have a unique primary key, so I'll set the primary key in the class. I want the data store to allocate a unique key for me, so I'll ask it to do that in the annotation. Saving the file causes the data nucleus enhancer to run in the background, making my class capable of being saved to the data store. Now we need to actually save to and query from the data store. JDO uses something called the Persistence Manager to interact with the data store. You get a JDO Persistence Manager using a Persistence Manager factory. Now, a Persistence Manager factory is analogous to a database connection pool, and it has some overhead associated with creating it. In order to be efficient in our application, we want to create a singleton instance of the factory and only create it once. If you remember, our JSP posts to the servlet, which then creates a guestbook entry object and should store it to the data store. We create a persistence manager from our factory. Next, we save the object by calling makePersistent. Then, we close our JDO persistence manager. That's it. Now let's go to our JSP and query for all the entries. We get the persistence manager again. I create a query with SQLite constructs and tell it which object I'm looking for. Finally, I execute the query and assign the results to a list which I can iterate through. Now with our JDO data store code in place, let's try it out. I go back to my local server, enter in an entry, and voila. The JSP posts to the servlet creates a new entry object, persists to our data store, and then redirects back to the JSP. The JSP then queries the data store and lists out the entries. I now have a fully functioning guestbook application. I want to share that with the world by deploying to App Engine. So I go back to Eclipse and click on the deploy icon in the top left corner. This brings up the deploy dialog box. You'll notice there's an error at the moment. That's because I've not yet set the application ID. I click on Project Settings, and then click on the link to the right, which takes me to the App Engine console. Every application on App Engine must have a unique application ID to identify it. I create a new ID, and then I go back to Eclipse and set the ID in my project. Now all I have to do is enter my account ID and password. App Engine will now compile my Java source code if needed, then package everything up in my web archive folder and send it up to the cloud. I can go back to my browser and navigate to my new guestbook application in the cloud. You've just seen how easy it is to go from creating a new project to deploying a working application on App Engine. But there's a lot more to the App Engine environment than we've demoed here, including authentication, mail, and the Memcache API. You can also easily use Google Web Toolkit to create modern Ajax frontends entirely in Java. Now, our Java language support isn't yet feature complete. We're giving developers early access to the product in order to solicit feedback as soon as possible and ensure that the end result meets your needs. To learn more, go to code.google.com/appengine.